877 Planner. And don't forget, you can find us online where, you might ask, boomersbraintrust.com. Of course, if you missed any previous program, the podcasts are all right there, subscriptions and all that stuff. Find our interviews, really, our guest segments, our first five. That's what's there right now. Working on getting Professor Plum's stuff up there still. But anyway, you go to boomersbraintrust.com for all of that. So this year's flu season, yeah, remember that? It wasn't all that long ago. But it brought lower rates of doctor's visits and death compared with last season. But yet, at the same time, and it's kind of unfortunate, we saw a higher rate of flu-related hospitalizations among baby boomers. That's according to a new report from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. The CDC tells us, and we know it's true. It's summer, of course. Now, not thinking about staying home. Chills and a fever are the last thing that's on your mind. But influenza actually is something that everyone, especially boomers, needs to stay aware of. Now, Dinah's here with some numbers, some advice, some off-season flu tips.
Yeah, you know, you forget about this stuff.
Well, of course you do. And then by the time you remember it and it comes back, it's too late.
Right. And boy, I'd love to see you get immunized this year, John Dean.
But I haven't.
Once again,
I've never
you've proven me wrong.
I've never done it. I haven't had the flu in 30 years.
I know. So this past flu season, as
yes.
you were mentioning, it was a fairly unpleasant one. And federal health officials say that is thanks in large part to the return of the H1N1. That virus
that was
the
old
one,
the swine flu from a few years ago,
2009,
right?
2009, that big pandemic. So just as in 2009, this last influenza season hit young and middle-aged adults fairly hard. And the flu also killed at least 96 kids and many elderly people. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention just got this report out. And during that 2009 pandemic, when H1N1 emerged for the first time, that's when they had close to like 350 kids die from the flu. So the good news is that the 2013 to 2014 flu season, it was not as bad as in previous years. By the way, the season ran from about mid-November of last year through the middle of last month. Flu activity peaked in the U.S. during the last week of December, and that's when a larger than usual percentage of doctor's visits were made by people who were suffering from flu-like symptoms. But those numbers were still smaller in contrast to the ones seen during the 2012-2013 flu season. Mm-hmm. So it would seem that we're, you know, gaining a bit of a foothold. But also during the 2013 to 2014 flu season, the percentage of deaths in the U.S. attributed to pneumonia or influenza, that peaked at 8.7% compared with a high of 9.9% in the previous season.
So it's getting better, I guess?
It is
what?
Getting better.
Is this.
But here's where it gets dicey, especially for those of us of a certain age. Those of us in the boomer generation, the rate of hospitalization for flu among baby boomers, folks who are from 50 to age 64 or 68, I guess actually was about 54 hospitalizations per 100,000 people during this last flu season. That's higher than the rate of hospitalizations during the last four flu seasons for that particular age group. So the CDC says the increase may have been due in part to a lower rate of flu vaccination in this age group.
Ah. So they're not getting vaccinated
and then they're getting... Right, and then they come down with it, and it's so bad that they end up having to be hospitalized.
Now you're telling me I need to do it, but I didn't catch it, so, you know, I guess all's well. Right?
I know. I don't know how you manage that. You must be really strong stock.
I do not know.
Well, this flu season, this last one, was also the first time since 2009 that the H1N1 flu strain was the predominant strain in circulation. That's according to the CDC. Now, flu activity this season started to decline in January and February, but there was this late season increase in illnesses caused by influenza B viruses. Influenza A and B are the two main types of flu viruses. And A, that virus dominated until March of this season. So although flu activity tends to dip in the summer months, we still see cases. Doctors are advised to consider flu as a potential cause of respiratory illness in the coming months. And the CDC figures come from 30 states and also New York City and Chicago. So they're not, you know, complete numbers necessarily for the entire nation.
Yeah, but they're the big cities,
but,
and you can figure
you know,
that it's probably good, the same.
Pretty good sampling.
Yeah.
So as we said, the flu season peaked in late December, January. Highest death rate from flu and pneumonia was 8.7% of all reported deaths at the end of January. But the available vaccines matched the circulating flu viruses really well.
Oh.
So well, in fact, that the FDA's Vaccines and Related Biological Products Advisory Committee says Next season's vaccines should keep the same formulation.
Okay. All right. So this is important information, and we're relating it now in the summer months.
Well, we're talking about this because, you know, flu usually hits the very young and the very old the hardest. And depending on the season, it kills a lot of folks, anywhere from 4 to 50,000 people a year in the U.S.
Between 4,000 and 50,000?
Is that insane?
Is that still?
That's over a long period of time. I mean, taking into account many, many years when we did not have the vaccination.
Yeah, right.
For whatever reason, the U.S. has a fairly low influenza vaccination rate. In 2012, it was around 45%. Now, what the CDC found is that if maybe 70% of the population had been vaccinated, they're thinking close to 4.5 million people would not have gotten sick, and 30,000 more would have stayed out of the hospital. So
that's according to the CDC.
That's according to the CDC. They're hoping that, you know, people are going to start getting this with, I guess what happens, this is amazing to me. CDC recommends that everyone who's 6 months and older get a flu vaccine every year. But a lot of people don't, and I'm sitting across the desk from one of them.
Yeah, exactly.
But here's the thing that gets me. You always hear about how vaccinations are in short supply, or they have a note up that says, but it turns out that every year, they actually throw away a lot of the vaccines that are absolutely unused. Nobody uses them. They have to throw them away because they're past their prime.
Well, so what are they telling people there's a shortage of these things, or they're saying that there's a shortage of other vaccines, but certainly not the flu vaccine?
Not the flu vaccine. And at one point, actually, they cited that during the 2012-2013 flu season, only 63% of health professionals had been immunized.
Well, see, there you go.
So you're in great company, John Dean.
All right, see? do what your doctor says.
Now,
all right?
As we mentioned earlier, Next year's flu vaccines for the 14-15 flu season, they're going to have the same strains of flu as this last one. So if you received a vaccination, here's where it gets important. If you did get a flu shot last year, this year's flu shot expires June 30th. In other words, boomers, roll up your sleeves, protect yourselves, all right? You want to make sure you are protected against the flu. We don't need everybody sick.
Right. Okay.
John.
So you...
Yes, I got mine.
You have to know, but you have to know that if you got it last year, you got to redo it.
You got to redo
again
it.
Again at some point.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. They're only good for a certain amount of time. So you need to get in there and get the booster. So...
Now, I'm still
seeing
people...
Most of the time, it's not going to really happen during summer. Most people are not off to the pharmacy to get your flu shot or to the doctor's office.
But, and really, I mean, when you think about it, why wouldn't you? I know there are people that are afraid of vaccines.
Oh, yes. They're
afraid of what it might cause. Somebody asked me again, why didn't you do it? And I said, I don't know, because I've never gotten it.
But never done it?
You know, it doesn't mean...
Why start now?
Well, yeah, but that's probably stupid logic on my part. Somebody said, well, you know, why would you give somebody a polio vaccine? You've never had polio.
No.
Well, you know, there you go.
Yeah,
so anyway, good stuff. All right, thank you, Dinah. If you need the Brain Trust, once again, it's boomersbraintrust.com. Click on the Ask the Brain Trust link for Dinah Smith and all the other folks behind the scenes. I'm Johnny Dean. Have a great day. We're